when you're dealing with mystical things, you have to be balanced with standardizing it, but not losing the mysticism around it. I think this is important. You know, you can't go too far in either direction. You have to have some sort of regulation, but what does that look like? And are we even there yet? I'm not sure. I think one of the biggest concerns that people have is how the crystals are sourced. When you understand the mining industry, you have to look at it a little bit differently. Because some people give a lot of feedback and say, you're hurting the earth by taking this crystal, but our whole culture is propped up by mining. You know, the copper in your walls, the technology in your cell phone. And then it becomes a moral debate going, are we exploiting them? Or are we helping them? Are we giving something to their economy so it make their lives better, or are we exploiting their economy? And that's a fine line that you would probably have to travel to that place and go and look at. The biggest secret is the dealer that you get it from, and networking and talking to the dealer. Well, how is this done? Why is it done this way? Like I had one dealer from India point out to me earlier this year, and he said to me, he goes, we have higher end stuff because we can afford to pay our workers more, where when you mass produce it, they pay them pennies on the hour. And I go, oh, I didn't think about that before. And so I'm able to carry that in my shop because I think the energy's better. But then you run the risk of people can't always afford the nicest tools, and you want to make it accessible for everyone. And so I think the thing that you have to be careful with is really understanding the availability of the mineral that you're dealing with. The thing that people have to remember about the mineral industry is minerals are mined from a very specific location. And they might be mined for 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 years, thousands of years. You know, the lapis mines in Afghanistan have been producing for 5,000 years. But then all of a sudden, one day, that mine goes away. What you bought one year in a specific formation that you had for a technique ends. And so then you have to find substitutes or different things to fill in the gaps for that. Things are constantly changing. You have to be respectful and aware of these really extraordinary gifts. You know, I guess it's a good way to practice the Buddhist philosophy of non-attachment.